and welcome to all my dear loving kids. How are you all? I'm Anakshi Kothiyal, your computer teacher. Okay, and I'm back again to teach you computers. Children, so far we have done with our lesson number 3, that is more on paint. Okay, and children, as you have all come to know that your first term examinations are about to start. Okay, so till much we have studied in these 10 assignments that will only come in your exam. Means these 3 lessons will come in your exam. Okay. So today I am going to discuss the exercises questions here. Okay. As I have already given these questions in our previous assignments. But still here I am also solving the answers. Those who haven't write down the proper answers, they can write it down from the by watching the video from here, and they can write down the answers in their notebook. Okay, and those who have done, they just simply recheck the answers. Okay, this video is a kind of a revision type for the first term examination. Okay, children, so let us get started with the exercises questions. Okay, come on to page number 38. Here comes the first question, that is fill in the blanks. Okay, in dash you can make changes in a part of the picture or an object. So obviously children, we are doing this chapter MS Paint, so obviously in MS Paint we can draw the images, we can do changes on it. Okay, so write down MS Paint. Okay, now come to the second part. The dash command is found in image group. We have studied about the 5 groups in the MS Paint. Yes, so options are given. So which of them is found in the image group? Select. Okay, select option we found in the image group. 2 types of selection we have studied, rectangular selection and freeform selection. Okay, now third one, rotate is used to change the dash of the selected image. When we use the rotate option, what it does? It changes the angle of the image. So write down angle. Okay, now the fourth one, the dash option helps to keep the selected area and delete everything outside it. Crop option. What crop option does? It the area which we have cropped, that much only will remain, and the rest of the part that will get removed. Okay, so crop option. Okay children, now come to the next question, that is question number 2. What is the question number 2? Write T or F, means true or false. Okay, so the first one, you can select the whole part of an image using select command in image group. Yes children, with the help of this select command, we can select the whole part of an image. So this statement is true. Write down T. The skew command is used to resize the image. No children, it will not increase or decrease the size of the image. It will just skew it. It will just make it slanted in a way. Okay. So this statement is false. Write down F. Now come to the third part. Flip horizontal option makes a mirror image. Yes children, it makes a mirror image. Flip vertical and flip horizontal. So this statement is true. Write down T. Fourth, flip vertical option does not change the position of an image to upside down. This statement is false. Write down F. It will change the image from the, it will make an, what it does? It will make an mirror image. It will change the direction of the image in upside down way. Okay. So children, here comes our question number 3. That is match the following. Okay, so our question number 3 is match the following. I will write down the direct answers in front of the options. Okay, what you will do, you will just match it in your book. So the first is skew command. What it is? Skew command. So what would be the answer children? What it does? It twists the image or drawing. What it does? It twists the image or drawing. Okay. Now the second one is rotate. What it does? It changes the angle of the selected image.
changes the angle of the selected image.
Now the third one, crop. What it does? It keeps the selected area and delete everything outside it. It what it does? Keeps
the selected area and deletes everything outside it.
Okay, now fourth, resize option. Resize option, it increases and decreases the size of the image. Okay,
increases and decreases the size
of an image. So these are the answers, children. I have written directly in front of that. You have to match it in your book. Okay, children, now come to the next question, that is question number 7. What is the question number 7, children? Yes. Write one word. Or answer the following in one word. The first option, first question, the option used to increase and decrease the size of an angle. Right now we have done in the match of the following. Okay, so the answer is resize option. Okay. Second one, the command that is used to select the whole or part of an image.
Yes, children, by using the select command, we can select the part or the whole drawing. Okay.
Third, the option that changes the position of an image to upside down.
Flip vertical option. Flip vertical option.
Now fourth one, which dialog box appears when we click resize in the image group? When we click the resize option in the image group, dialog box will appear. What that dialog box named? Yes, resize and skew. Okay,
so that dialog box name is resize and skew.
Okay, children,
dialog box.
Okay, now here comes a question number 8. Write short answers. First question, how many types of selections are there in MS Paint?
So what you will write down? There are 2 types of selection. What are they? Rectangular selection and free form selection.
Okay, now question number 2, differentiate between flip horizontal option and flip vertical option.
So just make a line in between, write down flip horizontal and here write down flip vertical. Okay, so the answer is flip horizontal option makes a mirror image and flip vertical option changes the position of an image to upside down. Okay,
so this is the answer of the second. Now here comes question number 3. What are the steps for cropping an image?
Write down steps to crop an image. Step 1. Select the part of an image you want to crop. Step 2. Click Home tab. Step 3. Crop option from image.
Okay, children, so this is the way you can crop an image. Okay, now question number 4. What is the use of maintain aspect ratio check box? So answer number 4. Okay,
maintain aspect ratio box is selected to resize the picture in right proportion automatically.
Okay, children. Here, this is the maintain aspect ratio box. Okay, here when we resize and skew the image, two options are there, horizontal and vertical. But when we click on this maintain aspect ratio, we have to fill only one value. The next value will get automatically filled by the computer. So that is known as the maintain aspect ratio box. Now children, next comes question number 9. Write long answers. The first question is, what are the steps for resizing an image? Okay, so write down
steps to resize an image. Step 1. Select the whole or part of a drawing. Okay. Step 2. Click Home tab. Step 3. Click Resize option in the image group. Okay, resize and skew dialog box appears. Step 4. Enter the percentage by which you want to change the picture size horizontally or vertically. Then at last click OK.
Okay, children. So these are the steps. Okay, these are the steps to resize an image. Okay, now next question. How can you skew an image? Okay, so write down steps to skew an image. Step 1. Select the whole or part of an image. Step 2. Click Home tab. Step 3. Click Resize in the image group. Step 4. Wait. Resize and skew dialog box appears. Step 4. Enter the amount of degree in horizontal and vertical boxes in the skew area to skew the image. Click OK. So this is the answer of the second question. Okay, children. Now here comes the next question. Question number 10, multiple choice questions. First part, after dash a drawing, you can resize, move, copy, rotate or crop it. Options, selecting, deleting, pasting and cropping. Obviously, children, after selecting a drawing, we can cut it, paste it, copy it, okay? Remove it, resize it, okay? Second, there are dash options to set your picture as a desktop background. Option A, 2, 3, 4, none of these. There are 3 options, yes, B part 3. What are they? Fill center, then fill center, then tiles. Okay, these are the options, 3 options. Third one, an image can be saved as a dash, icon, folder, symbol, desktop, background. We can save the image as a desktop background also. Okay, whatever you can draw, you can set it as your desktop background. Okay, fourth, resize option is used to dash the size of an option. Increase, decrease, increase and decrease, none of the above. Option C, resize, it will help you to increase and decrease the size of an image. Okay, children, so we are done with the exercises questions of this chapter. Now what you have to do, you have to go through this video and just recheck your answers just if you have written wrong, just correct them, okay? And those who have done, they just need to simply revise this chapter, okay? Watch the video and revise the chapter, okay? While doing the question answers. So children, this is enough for today in this video. We'll be meeting soon in the next video. Till then, stay safe, stay home, and all the best for the first term exams.